Hi, I'm Jeremy Fischer. I'm the Senior Technical Advisor for Jetstream. Today I'm going to be here to talk a little bit about getting online, getting an access to Jetstream, and how to use Jetstream. Jetstream is a new science and engineering cloud that's brought to you by XSEDE. Jetstream's purpose is to make a more user-friendly HPC environment for those who may not have used HPC before. Getting started on Jetstream isn't just as simple as going directly to the website. First thing you'll need to do is get an XSEDE portal account. To get an XSEDE portal account, you go to portal.xsede.org, and then you'll click the button that says Create an Account. And that will start the process, which is free and fairly simple. You'll give it personal information. You click the Submit button, and in a short period of time later, you'll get back your username and password. When you go to the XSEDE portal to sign up for your user account, they do have step-by-step instructions to walk you through getting your account. After you get your XSEDE portal account, you'll want to get a startup allocation. The startup allocation is fairly simple. It will require a few bits of information from you, including a current CV and an abstract of what you plan to do with Jetstream. Once you get your allocation, the first thing you want to do is show actually logging in to Jetstream. So you go to use.jetstream-cloud.org and then click the login button in the upper right-hand corner. You'll then go to a page where it asks you to continue on using your XSEDE credentials. And then you'll do a sign on through the XSEDE gateway. And then this will take you back to the Jetstream page logged in. In your initial login, you'll use the web interface to log into your account and then launch a virtual machine. Once you've selected an image and launched it, you wait for a few minutes for it to be provisioned on the system. Once it's ready, you'll get an email and then you can log in. You can use the scientific software that's already installed, or you can install your own. Once you have a workflow or scientific software that works for you, you can also customize and save your image by keeping that software on there for future use, making your workflow be reproducible and shareable with other people. You can also request that your image be shared in IU ScholarWorks and request a DOI, a digital object identifier, that can also be used for publishing purposes to give a persistent URL. One of the most important things for a Jetstream user will also be able to know where to find help. There's extensive written documentation at wiki.jetstream-cloud.org, and then you can always email the XSEDE help desk at help@xsede.org if you need further assistance. To recap, first you get a portal account at portal.xsede.org. After that, you log into the portal and get an XSEDE allocation, also at portal.xsede.org. Then you actually use Jetstream at use.jetstream-cloud.org. And finally, if you need additional help, you can get the documentation at wiki.jetstream-cloud.org or email help@xsede.org.